Much obliged. There at the shop. What you asked me to do.
Let's not discuss it.
No, what did that thing do to you?
If he were to take me back, that's death, Mr. DeWitt, or something so like it I cannot tell the difference.
Elizabeth!
Sure thing!
Don't give any ground! You need to die! Death to you all! Open fire!
Take long at all. All yours. Found some money.
Sam!
Hey, don't point that at me. Want to hold on to this? Okay, catch! Beyond that gate was a Comstock house.
Lady Comstock, how lovely to see you. Wonderful of you to make the journey, especially considering your painful death 19 years ago.
Lady Comstock?
The dress. The thing is mistaking me for my mother.
Your fingerprints do not seem to be your own today, Lady Comstock. Are you unwell?
This isn't going to work.
I think it can.
Your mother's dead, Elizabeth.
Yes. I think it's time I paid my respects. Let's head to where she's buried. There's the graveyard where my mother's buried.
Where are you going?
Come on.
What are we looking for?
There it is. They have her preserved in an airtight chamber. Her fingerprints will get us into Comstock House.
She's your mother.
A mother who abandons their child doesn't draw a lot of sympathy in my book.
Take a moment to think about what you're doing.
There. Will you open the door or do I have to go in without you? Mother. All locked up in there, huh? Looks like you and I have some common ground.
Let me do it.
No.
Let me do it.
Look on the other side.
Elizabeth, are you all right?
Where did she go?
Hold on, you need to rest for a minute.
No, I'm getting that hand.
Elizabeth, why is your mother a ghost?
She's not. He used me to power with that device, he opened up his tiny tear.
Your mother is raising the dead. Dead.
Why do you ask what?
When the delicious question is when.
The only difference between past and present
is semantics.
Lives, lived, will live.
Dies, died, will die.
If we could perceive time as it truly was,
what reason would grammar professors have to get out of bed?
Like us all, Lady Comstock exists across time.
She's both alive and dead.
She perceives being both.
She finds this condition disagreeable.
Perception without comprehension
is a dangerous combination. Look! Footsteps! She goes to unfinished business.
We have to follow her. Convince her to open the gate to Comstock House.
It's a shame you have need of her to enter Comstock House.
Frankly, she doesn't seem all that cooperative.
There is a way to bring her to reason.
Three truths you must discover first.
Truths which, in this world, Comstock has destroyed.
If only one of you had the power to alter time and space.
That would be a blessing, wouldn't it?
Well, they're sarcastic.
There's something off about Lady Comstock.
Yeah. I noticed.
No, you don't understand. She doesn't belong here. I brought something through. I'm just not so sure it was her. Some money. Want it?
It's a
open it?
You whore!
That's my mother.
I assure you, madam, my sexual interest in your dear prophet is non-existent.
And Madame Lutess.
Furthermore, the man is quite sterile. It's a lie. Come here, you little bastard! I want you out of my house!
Sterile.
That he decided to imprison. She deserved whatever Comstock did to her.
What did you mean before when you said Lady Comstock didn't belong here?
She's almost feral. It's like she's a reflection. I don't know. Secret message from the Vox Populi.
Secret codes?
Cipher should be around somewhere.
Can you open this?
All done.
Go ahead!
Done!
Do it!
On it! Need money?